water.
Got my water, and I got trail mix from Trader Joe's. So, I'm ready for this.
The Rodriguez Show.
Hey guys, this is Caesar Rodriguez from The Rodriguez Show and Carla and Caesar's Modern Life. It's my new show if you haven't checked it out. But I'm here today doing a solo video. I've never done this before. This is a reaction video. We're doing a reaction video, me by myself, not we, as in just me. Doing a reaction video to the new Kendrick Lamar project. It is called Mr. Morale and the Big Steppers. In terms of context, Kendrick Lamar has been around for a while, man. He first came onto the scene with Overly Dedicated. I mean, you know, slowly rising. You've never been known with the Kendrick Lamar project. Then Overly Dedicated, then Section 80, and then finally the debut album, Good Kid, Mad City. And then he went left with jazz-inspired To Pimp a Butterfly. Then after that, there was Untitled Unmastered. And then Damn. So, yeah, man. I don't even know what else to say. He's a legend, and I'm just excited to be here witnessing another installment in the discography of this artist. This is it, Mr. Morale and the Big Steppers, Kendrick Lamar. The first track is called United in Grief. United in Grief. Let's do it. Whoa.
Tell them. I've been going through something.
Ooh.
1,855.
My comparison's humble enough because time was imperative. Whoa.
Ooh.
I feel like it's only one answer to everything. I don't know where it is.
Whoa.
Popping a bottle with Claritin. Whoa. Is it my head or my arrogance?
Whoa.
Shaking and moving like what am I doing? I'm flipping my time through the Rolodex. Indulging myself in my life and my music. The word that I'm in is a cul-de-sac.
Mm.
The word that we...
Whoa. What the fuck?
The new Mercedes with black G-Wagon away from. It was all for rapture. Pray none of my enemies hold me captive. I grieve different.
Damn.
Grieve different.
Wow. Damn, that piano though. Oh my god, that was incredible, man. And right away you can tell just from what he's saying and just the I grieve different, like... He's going through some stuff and the drums, it's weird because, you know, so somebody that goes through anxiety, like that's how your head gets going when you're in an anxiety mood. So that was really interesting how he presented basically, this is where I'm at right now and I'm going through some shit. And he says it right off the top. Wow. I think this was like a leaked snippet, which is amazing that leaked snippet. It became what it is now. Next track. This is the next track. It is called N95. Let's do it.
Hello, new world. All the boys and girls. Oh, yeah.
Take off the foo-foo. Take off the cloud chase. Take off the Wi-Fi. Take off the money phone. Take off your idols. Take off the runway. Take off the Cairo.
Holy shit.
Take off the Sandro. Pay 5 days stay. Take off for the meal. Hella follow. Take off the far flat. Take off all that designer bullshit. Off and what do you have?
Bitch.
This ain't monogamy, y'all getting fucked. Never know what the hell is that. I gotta relax when I feel. All my descendants, they come in my sleep and say I am too real.
What the fuck is council culture, dog? Say what I want about you niggas. I'm like overdog.
Ooh. I treat you. N95. Oh my god, what a track. That was that's what I was gonna say at the beginning. It just feels like it's elevated to the next level. And beats like this and this kind of, you know, top tier rhymes. I have to take that in because that was an amazing track. This is not like he was like, yeah, I know, like I'm going through some shit, but I could still rap and I'm still gonna talk about real shit. And this beat is fire, man. And this is just the first two tracks, guys. Worldwide Steppers is the next track. Let's do that right now.
Call that black. Okay, Lama.
Whoa.
I'm a killer, he's a killer, she's a killer.
That's life regressions, keep me in question. Where did I come from?
Ooh.
I don't think like I used to. No, I don't blink like I used to. Vacation to the powers that be. Synchronization with my energy chakras.
Oh, wow.
Pale, like the first time I fucked a white bitch. The first time I fucked a white bitch, I was 16 at the Palisades, fumbling my grades. I traveled with the team, the Apache life. Centennial was like when Miss Baker screamed cars and family plans. She drove her daddy's Benz. I found out that he was a sheriff. That was a win-win because he had locked up Uncle Perry. She paid her daddy's sins. Next time I fucked a white bitch was.
Kendrick, he's opening up even more than we would expect.
8 billion people on earth, silent murderers, non-profits, preachers in church, crooks and birdies. You either go be dead or in jail, killer psychology, silent murderer. What's your body count? Who your sponsor? Just impose for the pick.
Worldwide Steppers was dope. This is so Kendrick has beats that are unique and they're, you know, amazing so far. But then the piano kind of thing, it just feels so cinematic. Like, I'm looking at the artwork as I'm, you know, because there's not even lyrics printed for this yet. So I'm looking at the artwork and you just see, like, this movie of his life. Like, this guy that's trying to balance everything. It's already kind of has a theme going. Honestly, it feels like Late Registration with, like, how Kanye, he had the beats and then he brought in the orchestra. But it feels like he, instead of Kendrick bringing the orchestra, he brought in, like, a film score. Like, he brought in fucking Atticus Ross and Trent Reznor to do a score, because, you know, every Kendrick project has, like, you know, there's like a theme or like a flow to it, and this is like a movie, but like, in, or I don't know, like a stage play, I guess. It does have the sense of like the grab, like, because of the piano and the movement, and even the introduction by Kodak Black, it would just seem like he was like on stage doing it. Wow. Track number 4, this is Die Hard featuring Blast and Amanda Reefer. Damn, I'm so ready for this. Okay.
I pop the pain away, I slide the pain away. I pop the pain away, I slide the pain away.
Not too late.
Oh my God.
Set my demon straight. I know I made you wait.
Wow.
How much can you take?
Power 106.
Up, stay down for me.
Real 92.3. Ooh. Ooh, if you listen to the radio, this is gonna be played for years.
Can I open up? Is it safe or not? I'm afraid a little you relate, but no.
I hope you see the God in me. I hope you can see.
This is so good. Die Hard, Kendrick Lamar, Blast, and Amanda Reefer. That was an amazing track. That is, it was like, he was like, he made a song that Drake could have, like, if Drake could make a song like that again, you know what I'm saying? Like, it was very, you could feel the influence of Drake, and but still, you know, that was amazing. It was like next level. And so now I see it. It's like a combination of everything we've had so far. This is definitely Kendrick Lamar evolving. You know, this, you got the cinematics, you got the piano, you got everything, but then you have this is like an elevated, I keep using that word, but it's like an elevated of what it could have been on Damn, like to the next level. Shout out to my wife Carla, got home from work right now, and we're gonna continue with this next track, Father Time, featuring Sampha.
And I got daddy issues, ooh, that's on me. Everything them four walls that taught me, may have is buried deep. That man knew a lot, but not enough to keep me past them streaks. My life is a plot, twisted from directions that I can't see. Daddy issues, ooh, all across my head, told me fuck a foul.
Good morning, wake up.
Damn.
Practicing on day offs, tough love. Bottled up, no chase on me, no chase on me, no chase on me, no chase on me, no chase. Early morning, wake up.
Fire.
Look, man should never show feelings. Being sensitive never helped. His mama died, I asked him why he going back to work so soon. His first reply was, son, that's life. Your bills got no silver spoon.
Ooh.
Daddy issues, fuck everybody. Go get your money, son, protect yourself. Let's give the women a break. Grown men with daddy issues.
Damn. Wow. Father Time featuring Sampha. That was a beautiful song about a beautiful topic that's very hard to deal with, you know. Damn, you know, toxic masculinity, because you pass that on to the people if you are, you know, you pass that on to the next generation if you're doing that, if you're a father doing that to your son, or you know anyone doing to somebody younger. And this is what happened to Kendrick, and it's just so sad. And wow, Kendrick, the drums are amazing. Sampha was just an amazing hook, and such a catchy song too. Like, Kendrick is just delivering on every single aspect, the pianos, the cinematic introduction. I feel like it's a stage play now. I feel like it's coming together in that sense. This is called Rich Interlude. This is a sixth track.
I learned in trapping in the business, smart people making horrible decisions, you know? Rich nigga get my dick sucked after the show. I ain't gonna lie, we will. So what they call you? When it's all said and done, we ain't leaving empty-headed. That's some game. That's some mon dukes. Pour it in the bitch, but you fall through. Bacon ends meet daddy dead.
Wow.
Had to steal for a meal or you can't eat, you know? Poverty. Bread costs, food banks, wick. Now look at this shit, we own property.
I can't believe that. Rich, what? Kodak Black, he addressed my, you know, I wasn't a big fan of, I'm not a big fan of Kodak Black, but wow, that was incredible. This reminds me of like something Kanye would do. But I mean, he's, wow, I just blew me away with that one. Kodak Black, man, wow. And he's on another song, so this is gonna be something to dive into, this relationship with Kendrick and Kodak on this thing. But so far I'm enjoying it sonically, you know what he's saying. I really like the flow of his voice and everything. So hey, no hate right here, man. Let's just keep going. This is Rich Spirit.
Taking my baby to school, then I pray for it. Cause you bitches ain't never been cool. Writing testament, painting pictures, put me in the Louvre, that's a definite.
Ooh.
Russell Schiff, I'm in the groove. It's celebrity to rap, mean integrity, bring you to a song.
Damn.
Bitch, I'm attractive. Can't fuck with you no more, I'm fasting. Bitch, I'm attractive. Can't fuck with you no more, I'm fasting.
Damn.
Secretly, I'm running out of space. Ask Winnie, she okay? Never mind a 100K. Why you lying?
I love the sample.
Mini turning in his grave. I'd be lying if I said I wouldn't get it. Should ask him.
This song is so fire. I can't believe it. Like, wow.
Frat brother, 4 days out the week, brother. I pray to God that you realize the entourage is dead. I pray to God that you not lagging when you off the meds. I pray to God she know them
partnerships
don't last forever. Bitch, you arguing with me before I turn you to a song.
Damn.
Bitch, I'm attractive. Can't fuck with you no more. I'm fasting. Bitch, I'm attractive.
Bitch, I'm attractive. That's so fire. Bitch, I'm attractive. What can I say about that track? It's like next level shit. Like these beats produced by Soundwave. According to Genius. Wow. That was an amazing track. Rich Spirit, the beat. It was just like, it's like we're in the future. This is like amazing. This one's called We Cry Together featuring Taylor Page. Florence and the Machine kind of shit.
Fuck you.
Oh, this is Zola? Shut up.
Fuck you, nigga. You love a bitty party. I won't show up.
Ooh.
Always act like your shit. Don't stink. Motherfucker, grow up. Forever late for shit. Won't buy shit. Sit, bitch, I don't know shit. Fuck your feelings.
Ooh, shit.
I don't know why you like
fuck you. Fuck you.
Fuck you.
Fuck you,
fuck you, nigga.
But you were sucking his dick though.
Well shit, I should've sucked his.
What you say?
I should've found a bigger dick.
Bitch, get the fuck out of my face.
Oh what, you mad?
Shut up, God, you ain't getting these keys.
Give me my fucking keys.
Ah, now you mad at me. I got you hollering for nothing.
I do the same when we fucking.
Act like that pussy ain't loose.
I'd rather act like I'm coming.
I'd rather fuck off the juice.
I'd
my number, I'm ducking you, bitch.
Bitch, whatever is comfortable.
This the type of shit couples do. Should've thought about.
Nigga, you fucked up. Why they say it's a man's world? See you overlooked, underpaid, underbooked, and recognized that he's abusive.
Man, shut the fuck up. We all know you still playing this music. Said I'm tired of these emotional ass doggy style, then you get on top.
Fuck me, nigga.
I'ma fuck you, bitch.
Nah, fuck me, nigga. Fuck me.
I'ma fuck you, bitch.
Wow, we cried together. That was a skit. It was like, this dig ain't free, but to the next level, like I've been talking about, elevating old elements. But this was created in such a way that I think, yeah, this is like a movie or a fucking play or whatever it is, but it really puts like a vivid picture in your head. There's a song by The Game where he kind of does a similar thing, but this seems like adapted to whatever's going on. It just feels like a movie. Wow. So we cry together. Taylor Page, shout out. That's she's seen the movie Zola. She was in that. Recognized her voice right away. That was a cool skit in the context of what's going on. Speaking about toxic masculinity. And all right, this is the end of side one. This is Purple Hearts, featuring Summer Walker and Ghostface Killah. Wow. Nice.
Tippy torn and I'm a walking.
Ooh.
I'm a walking.
Ooh.
Rolling sevens, I ain't ready for no
coming. How's love when it's hard to your soul? But my nigga. Now if it's love, I deserve to get some hair on a balcony.
Yeah.
Judge me for my past. No, it ain't love if you ain't ever eat my ass.
Summer Walker, that was interesting.
While I'm crying, I clean the feet of the sweet Jesus. Dreams, visions get.
No, y'all love it when the drugs talking. But
shut the fuck up when you hear love
talking. Shut the fuck up when you hear love talking.
Dope. Yeah. No, that one. Yeah, it was good. Yeah, I would say it wasn't like, you know, my favorite out of all of them, but I would say it was pretty good. Summer Walker, she had some good lines in there. Ghostface Killah, I loved his voice on that. Yeah, Purple Hearts. Yeah. All right. So that was the end of side one. I'm moving on to the first track of side two. This is called Count Me Out.
Session 10. Breakthrough.
One of these lives, I'ma make these right with the wrongs. Ooh. I've done. That's one of you not with the father, son, too. The fame to me is a game to me with a bedroom at. Sleep, I ain't never had a fest with that. What's fair when the heart's in the
those vocals. Reach?
What's fair when the money don't take things back? Tell all my angels carry on.
Some gospel.
Every emotion been deprived.
But rock, guitar, I don't know.
Survive. If I didn't learn to love myself, forgive myself 100 times, dog.
Okay.
I love when you count me out. I love when you count me out. Fuck it up, fuck it up, fuck it up, fuck it up, fucking it up. How you gonna wear my shorts when the lines run deep? I love when you count me out. I love when you count me out.
Damn.
I love when you count me out. You worry.
I love this part.
I wanted my best version, but
your guitar's on there.
Then change the story. Then change the story. I love when you count me out. I love when you count me out. My name is in your mouth. Fuck it up, 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 fuck it up. Anybody fighting through the stress? Anybody fighting through the...
So wow, that was Count Me Out. This is definitely the second. This is the second, like, we just had an intermission between the sides, and this is the continuation of the first story. And wow, does it balances between some 70s, I think, guitar and backup vocals, and then hits you with a real big electronic chorus. And man, this was a really interesting way to start part two. Count Me Out. Wow. Let's continue with Crown.
The closest ones afraid to say they need some time. Turn around, it's life or death, but you don't be there when somebody needs you. You say no, and all you don't give them amnesia. One thing I've learned, love can can change with the season. Promise that you keep the music in rotation. That's what I call love.
Wow. Crown, what an interesting track. Wow, this is him burying his soul over something that you can't, there's no like drums on this. This is all just vocals and piano. And I just picture Kendrick on a stage with a spotlight on him, like in a therapist office, and this is just straight basically him trying to, you know, talk about what's going on. And wow, that's gonna take a couple listens to really digest, but so far it's just so painting a picture, you know, like he doesn't care, like he gave you the radio hits already with the first side, and now this is something I can't even describe, you know. Silent Hill, this is the next track.
Why you keep fucking with me?
What?
You gon' make me jump out my...
Oh, shit. He's like, don't worry, we got drums now. We got a lot of drums for you. Bass.
Push these niggas off me like, huh. Push these bitches off me like, huh. Peekaboo, can't hide behind your money, dog.
Hey.
Two, I meditate on running law. Pushing the snakes, I'm pushing the fakes, I'm pushing them all off me like, pushing them all off me like, yeah. Head up, chest out, silence, I'm stressed out. It's like 6 o'clock, bitch, you talk too much. You making it awkward, love. I mean, it's hard enough. Hit a bitch with the wood. First part roll was breaking the hood. Don't worry about us over here, we good.
Damn.
Roman numeral. Everybody go, I need pharmaceuticals. I ran my whole conglomerate. I was just mapping shit out in the cubicle. Suicide cool is a funeral. Oh. Push these niggas off me like,
ooh.
Push these bitches off me like, huh. Push these niggas off me like, huh.
So that was Silent Hill, Kendrick Lamar, and Kodak Black. Wow. That was another radio hit. I just feel like every time you think this is going to go somewhere, it just makes it goes the other way. Like, we just had Crown, which is very, you know, not the opposite, basically, of Silent Hill. Like, those songs, they have nothing, like, that was such a mood switch. And that's going to have to take some deeper analyzation, but that was dope, though. That song, like, I could see myself, and Kodak Black, like, I feel like he's delivering some of the best verses I've heard from him ever. And of course, like, he would have to do that if he's going to be in a song with Kendrick Lamar, multiple songs with Kendrick Lamar. So, wow, shout out Kodak Black. I never thought I'd be saying that in my life. Shout out Kodak Black. all right, this is the next one. It's called Savior Interlude.
Develop a sense of self that is based on the bad things that happen to you.
You ever seen your mama strung out while you studied division? Your uncle ever stole from you day after Christmas? Seeing both of those in the mama. She's showing a pattern for certain. I think it's white panties and minimal condoms.
Whew.
My uncle would tell me the shit in the movies could only be magic. I'm gonna rack up. I need the advance and the equity to match up. The engineer dead if the drive don't back up. These words come from God, you can never out-rap us. Nowadays, gotta walk cautious. Hey, now Lambo body, who gonna stop me? Baby, Keeman's too wild. Function at the temple, Jesus pieces in the luau. Mr. Moral.
Wow, baby Keem. It's like his character's being introduced. Like, this is him. Like, I'm here now. And he's gonna be a character throughout the rest of this. That's what it feels like to me.
Kendrick made you think about it, but he is not your savior. Cole made you feel empowered, but he is not your savior. Ron made you give his flowers, but he is not your savior. He's not your savior.
Mr. Morale, give me high five. 2 times in a code offended, judging my life. Backpedaler, more Kodak Black. Tell me where the money at, ay. Where the homies at, universal call out. I can remember only that, ay. CC, wait a minute. Ben Aki,
hey.
C'est la vie, c'est la vie. I tell a hoe,
Those drums.
I tell on me, bitch, are you happy for me? Millie, are you happy for me? Smile on my face, but are you happy for me? Yeah, I'm on the way. Are you happy for me?
And watch us in the street.
Just for you.
You're precise in the fire. The need of his dire. Deceiving the lies I know. Truth, you're precise in the fire.
Wow, this is, I think this is Kendrick, you know, his realization that he doesn't have to, like, that we idolize people like him too much, which is a crazy thing to say because I think people need to hear it. But what an interesting way to do it. What a catchy song. Baby Keem got fire verse and his voice just sounds great on this. This is, you know, I got some, you know, Good Kid, Mad City vibes with some of the background vocals, but the samples. Like, it just... It's like Kendrick's elements all coming together like perfectly, you know? Wow. We have a few more tracks to go. Auntie Diaries.
Hot place and ways the mind can't figure out.
This is how we conceptualize human beings.
Monty is a man now. I think I'm old enough to understand now. Drinking Parmesan with her hat turned backwards. Motorola pager off white guest jacket. At the parties, why they always want to fight him that much? She said, ain't no telling. Niggas always been jealous because he had more women. More money and more attention made more envy. Calling him anything but broke was less of. She wasn't gay, she ate pussy, and that was the difference. That's what I told my friends in second grade. She picking me up from school, they stare at her in the face. Behavior.
Demetrius is Marianne now.
He's more confident to live his plan now. But the family in disbelief this time, convincing themselves he ain't living discreet, he's fine. They said they never seen it in him, but I seen it. The Barbie dolls played off reflection of Venus. He built a wall so tall you couldn't climb over.
Thank you, the day I chose humanity over religion. The family got closer, it was all forgiven. I said them F-bombs, I ain't know any better. Mistakenly, I ain't think that you know any different. See, I was taught words was nothing more than a sound you said together. But only if you let a white girl say nigga.
Wow, that was such a great Kendrick song, and it had such a beautiful message, and it's funny that he put this song right after the song about how he doesn't have to say anything important, and then he says something very important, it's gonna make a difference. And that was amazing for Kendrick to do that. I mean,
I've seen in my life,
Mr. Morale,
I couldn't sleep last night because I felt this shit.
Whoa.
Father's just detox, my calling is right on time. Transformation, I must have
every
my
wow.
The Joker is heavy. More life to give on the men, are you ready? Who keep them honest like us?
In a way,
this is dope.
Uzi, your father's in deep meditation. My spirit's awakened, my brain is asleep. I got a new temperature. Sharpening multiple swords in the faith I believe.
Oh my God. Wow, that was Mr. Morale. What an interesting track, man. This is another level that I just can't comprehend now. Like, this is like some industrial shit, man. The drums in there were just, the beat was like, you know, club music, you know what I'm saying? Like, the drums are just immense. Very, very overpowering, that one. We just got a couple tracks left. This one's called Mother/Sober. Featuring Beth Gibbons.
I wake up at night, loved her daily, traded in my tears for a Range Rover. Transformation, you ain't felt grief till you felt it sober.
I wish you were somebody.
Life and nature, only thing believes me. Spirit God, whisper in my ear, tell me that she sees me. Did he touch you? I said no again. Still they didn't believe me.
Wow.
Brother.
He's just going deeper and deeper with what's been going on with him and what, you know, why he has the issues that he does. Damn.
What happened? She wouldn't agree. Now I'm a affected. 20 years later, trauma has resurfaced, amplified. As I write this song, I shiver cause I'm nervous.
So I set free our children, make a karma, keep them with God. So I set free the hearts filled with hatred, keep our bodies sacred. As I set free all your abusers, this is transformation.
Anybody but myself.
You broke a generational curse. Say thank you, Dad.
Thank you, Daddy. Thank you, Mommy.
Oh, wow.
Thank you, Brother.
Mother sober. Wow. So this was his breakthrough in therapy, was him speaking the truth about what happened to him when he was younger and how it affected him, what he saw happen to his mom. And wow, what a track. It just, you could tell, like even he said that he was shivering when he wrote it, that it's just, wow. Kendrick Lamar, man. It's just another side of him that we didn't even know was there, you know? And what he's saying about, you know, the cycle of abuse, and how it's only going to break if you go to therapy. That's true. Damn. Wow. We have one more track, the final track on the second side. It's called Mirror.
I choose me.
Hey, nice. Oh, this is some 80s sounding shit right here.
Sorry, I didn't save the world, my friend. I was too busy building mine again. I choose me, I'm sorry. I choose me, I'm sorry. I choose me, I'm sorry.
Wow. Mr. Morale and the Big Steppers by Kendrick Lamar. What an album. Meticulously planned work of art. Every single aspect of it. The things he covers are just about himself. And you know, specifically, before I even move on to the entire album, the song Mirror, just about, you know, letting all that shit go and saying, this isn't my responsibility. I can't carry the world on my shoulders. And that's what he's saying at the end of this. And he can't, like, his whole point, even back to where Savior is saying, I can't be responsible for the entire world. Like, I'm sorry you expected this much of me, you know? And he's letting that go and choosing himself. That's what he's saying. And he's still, you know, it's just, the entire thing is just telling you, you have to go to therapy, just work through your issues and be able to talk about what's going on in your life. You know, on first listen, I have to say it reminds me a lot of, you know, Dr. Dre's 2001, in the sense of, you know, it has a cinematic scope, and it does have this theme of therapy and using a therapy session. So that, wow. Yeah, this is all the 18 tracks. I mean, some highlights here, the N95, Die Hard with Blast, Crown was just, took you on a journey for the second half, which was even deeper in his, you know, issues of his, what he's dealing with in his life in terms of therapy and his past. And, you know, and he makes an interesting point, you know, that's about, you know, how even, you know, even myself, I'm guilty about, you know, pointing fingers, but you don't know the entire picture of how this is a cycle. And so when Kendrick sees somebody going through, you know, a scandal or something, he thinks about the cycle, not just, hey, this person did something bad. And it's a sad picture. It's not just attacking people. And even, you know, with the connection of the Heart Part 5, right, the idea of, like, this is the culture that we're living in, and he's just like, you know what, like, at the end, in Mirrors, he's like, I can't with this anymore, like, I'm gonna leave that behind, because I can't carry this weight, like I said, this weight on my shoulder of, you know, this entire community looking at me as a savior, which is what we do, and this is, you know, why I'm recording this, because it's like, oh, shit, it's Kendrick, you know, he's telling us what's next from Kendrick. We're all, like, on his every word, and he's telling us, like, hey, you need to find something for yourself. You can't be like this. I mean, I guess, you know, I think I admire him a healthy amount, but, you know, there's some people that can, you know, they go too far. And that's what he's trying to say. It's a statement on, and you know, putting everything into one person. He says that in the song too. So that's it. That was my reaction. There's going to be more, of course, you know, as I listen to it more. And, you know, you can follow that on the Rodriguez Show as we talk about this album next week. And, you know, we're going to talk about it, you know, the day after this recording to do a first impressions live chat and stuff like that. So, yeah, this is going to definitely require more listening. And thank you for tuning into this video. Shout out to everybody. Tune in every Friday to the Rodriguez Show, 10 a.m. on youtube.com/c/TheRodriguezShow, and you can follow my other show, Carla and Caesar's Modern Life, and just look for that. You can go to carlaandcaesar.com and it'll be on the screen as well, and patreon.com/TheRodriguezShow. That's where you can support the Rodriguez Show for $1 a month to get the show as soon as it's done. And we're definitely gonna be playing some of this new Kendrick on the show. And all right, guys, thank you for watching this, and I'll see you soon. Keep it funky, keep it fresh, keep it sexy. We out.